Want some awesome video captions that look like this, or this, or this? That's what I'm going to show you how to do right now. When we bring in our audio or our video, if it has audio attached to it, when we drop it into Descript, or if we record it directly into Descript, it automatically transcribes. So we have the transcription already there. That's going to make our life a lot easier because we don't have to type out what we want our captions to say. It's already here. And Descript is going to automatically sync that up with when the audio is being spoken and our video and our final product. We can just click on our video right here over in the canvas. We'll come up to templates up here in the insert menu, and then we'll come down to where it says captions. That's the last thing I had open, so it's already open. We can pick from any of these styles here. These templates are all a great place to start. Even if you want to tweak them, you don't like exactly what you see, they're a great place to start. So we'll pick one here. We'll just take this top one, the karaoke classic. It'll have the captions in a white text. And then as the word is being said, it'll have this blue highlight behind it. I've muted the audio so that you don't have to listen through all that, but let's play through and you just see what it does. So as each word is said, you can see that it puts the blue background behind that specific word. We didn't have to line anything up. We didn't have to tell it what to say. Our audio was already transcribed here into this transcript. So that was done for us. And it already has it synced up with the video. Easy peasy. You can pick any one of those, and I'll take you back here because there are plenty of different templates to pick from. If you want them off at an angle, that's not a problem. Oops, we've got to delete the one we had in before. So we just select it, delete, it's gone. Now we've added this one. Do you want it at an angle? No problem. We can take that out. We can go down and see some of the other templates are in different colors, different styles. This is called clean. What this one does is just as each word is said, it puts it up on the screen and then it leaves some of the previous spoken words up there until there's a cut. We've got some other styles in here that we can play with. We've got karaoke one word, and that just puts one word at a time up on the screen. What else do we have up here? We can have a yellow highlight. We want to go that route. The text is white, and then the word as it's being spoken, it changes to yellow. Try this outline here. The animation and the live text somehow highlighting or indicating the word that's being spoken has become very, very popular. I believe that's because it really helps with retention. I don't know about you, but I know it happens to me. When there's this kind of text on there, I'll end up, my eyes will lock in and follow the moving words. And time has gone by before I even realize, like, you know, what am I doing here? Even if it's a video that I otherwise might not have stuck around for, the text moving sort of keeps my attention. Maybe it's just me. You just want two words on at a time, no problem. They can do that too. Now that little blue box won't be there. The little blue box is just because I have that element selected. If I come off of it and click anywhere else, you can see it just shows the text, but that one's showing two words at a time. So let's go back and pick one that has a little more going on with it. Let's do this one, karaoke future transparent. Here's one that's pretty cool. So what this one will do is the text that's already been spoken, it'll be in white. The live text, the active word, the word that's being said right now, it'll be white with the background in blue. And then the text that's coming up, the things that haven't been said yet but are about to be said, those will be a little bit transparent, sort of grayed out a bit. I like that one. That's one I tend to use a lot. And so we can, here, let me show you what it looks like. As the word's being said, it turns white and then stays white. But as the word's being said, you get the blue background. And then once it passes on to another word, it just stays white. You get the point. Why am I explaining? If we start with something like this and we want to make some tweaks to it, it's really easy to get it to be exactly what you want it to. Make sure that you have the caption selected. If you end up off of it somehow, say we're clicked on this video or we're over here in the script, you just come over here and when you hover your mouse over top of the caption, you'll see the blue bounding box come around it. You just click and then you'll get the four little points in the corners, the four little white dots. You can also see the captions down here in your timeline. It's labeled over on the left, captions, and we've got it running the whole length of this particular video. This is a very short video. So what we can do with the captions selected, we can come over here and you see now that in your properties panel, the heading is now captions. That's telling you you're working on your captions. You can change all kinds of things here. If you want transparency, you can lighten the opacity there, make it lighter or full. I'm going to leave it at 100%. You can over here set the X, Y, the length, width, all that kind of stuff. I think it's easier to just grab it here and drag it where you want it. But if you need to be very precise for some reason, you can set that there. This is the text. So we're using the font Roboto. We could change that if we wanted to use some different font. The fill, this is going to apply, and the best way to figure out what's going to affect what is to really look over here and see what they are now. So you've got this fill color and it shows that it's white. Now let's come down here. We're going to hit the little settings underneath of live text. And now we have some more options. So we can see we have fill is white, background is blue, and future words, fill is sort of transparency, which makes it gray. If I want this blue background as the words being said, if I'm going to change that and make it red, I can just change that color right there. This is under active word. If I want the future words to be completely black, like a solid black, instead of having any transparency, I can just drag this little transparency deal over to 100%. Now those would be black. And then if I want to get even more creative, I want it to be a yellow foreground and a red background as the word is being said. There we go. We can change that right there. Now the fill up here, right under where we selected the font, this fill is only going to affect the words that have already been said, not the ones that are upcoming, not the active word that's being said at this moment. So if we click on this fill, and we're getting an awful lot of colors here, but let's make that gray, not probably something I'd do, but now our gray is a word we've already said. And as we look down on our captions under live text, this is where it's showing us the fill for the active word and the background for the active word, and then the fill for the future words. All right, so this gray is a little crazy. I think we need to get rid of that. We're going to take that back to white. Seems good. I'm actually okay with the solid black on the upcoming word, but let's go back and get rid of this yellow. Well, I play it a second so you can see what happens. Yeah, I think, I don't know about you, but I think I would rather the fill on the active word to just go ahead and stay white and use the red background. That seems a little bit better, right? If we wanted to cut this down, say we only wanted one line of text here or something, by changing the size of the box, that changes how many rows of text can appear in there. So we can drag this out and get, a whole bunch of rows. That just seems like an awful lot to have on there. But hey, if that's your thing, you do you. If we want fewer lines than that, just sort of shrink this up. Two lines seems to be about the going rate these days. There we go. You can do other things here. If you want a border around the text, and I don't know if you can see that right there, but we just click the plus sign next to border, and then we have our line size. We can choose how thick we want the border to be, and then we can choose the color we want the border to be. I'll change the color so you can maybe see what it did. Yeah, that seems a bit much. No one would ever do it like this. I mean, at least I hope no one would ever have these colors going on. I'm just doing that so you can see where it goes. When you try to put the captions over a video that sort of goes through some really light colors and some really dark colors, well, then it can be handy to have a border on there. But you're probably going to want a border that's not so wild. I don't know, whatever you want to call it. And 13 is probably a bit much. I don't know. We'll take it down to like 10. Seems a lot better. I think bring it up here. Let me see if I can find a spot. So here you can see where the border makes the white actually pop up. It gets funky with the black, but I think you get the point. We can also background the whole thing. So if you want everything behind the words to have a color, you can do that. And all I did there was went to background, click the plus button. There you go. If you want to change the color of that background, come in here, pick any color you like. Ditch that background because I think we're just fine without it. Another way you can add your captions, if you don't want to work from a template, hit the T up on the insert menu, come down and click captions. What it's going to do when you do that is it's going to drop in whatever the last style is that you use. So this is the style we just created and put on this video. And it does seem to go across from, if we go start a new video, a new project and start working on it, this is what would come in. So it's bringing you in the latest captions that you used. So that can also be pretty handy if you're using the same thing or you're doing multiple videos. You don't have to fiddle with anything over and over again. We clicked captions and it brought in captions in the exact style that we used the last time. And we can edit from there. We can also, if you want some of the real basics, we can also come over here to captions. We can hit the settings. You see we have live text. You can filter these by speaker so that if you have used speaker labels over in your script and identified who's talking when, it would only show when certain speakers are talking. I don't really need to do that. But if we come down here under custom, we have karaoke, classic, clean. And so karaoke, we looked at that one. It's where we have the white text, the blue background on the spoken word, and then the sort of transparency on the future words. Classic looks like this. it's really just the words coming up. There's no active word being highlighted. There's no color changes going on. And of course, you can edit those however you want. And then the other set that they have in here is the clean, and clean has the active word, and the any word that's been said, including the active word, will be in the selected color, and then future words will have a separate color. Usually what I like to start with, again, I try and start with the thing that's as close to what I want to do as possible. And for me, that's going to be karaoke. I think I like the white text. I like the transparent coming up. And we'll go ahead and change our background. We can make it that bright yellow. That's a good one. Seems pretty popular. So you see, there's what it's doing. All right, so we got our captions. We like what we got here, but we've only got it on one scene, and there's two scenes in this. You can look in the scene rail, see that we have two different scenes. If I want the same captions that I just created on this scene as well, I would just come over and I can double click on the timeline here to select the whole scene, or I could accomplish the same thing by clicking the scene over in the scene rail and then come up and hit the T and captions. And now it has added the captions to that second scene as well. I can also just come down to the timeline and see I have captions on the first scene, but not on the second scene. I can just grab that and drag it down to the end. So now those same captions are all across the whole thing. If I wanted to make some changes in the captions from point to point, that's where it'd be really handy to, instead of dragging this off to cover the whole thing, go ahead and apply the same captions to the next scene by just selecting the scene here, T, and this is where I could make a change. If, say, for this scene, I wanted to change it to red, or this scene, I wanted to make it just one row instead of two, then changes that I make here wouldn't apply to how I had things laid out in the first scene. Sometimes there's a word here or there that you want to emphasize, but you don't necessarily want the captions to run through the whole video. You can select a word. And what I did is I just double clicked this 1979 up here in the script. And then I go hit the T and captions. And now what that did is that put 1979 in its own separate scene by itself. Notice it put a forward slash before and after it. And you can tell over here it put it in a separate scene by itself. So now when we play through, not seeing anything, boom, 1979 popped up. Instead of having to create a title and decide where it goes and all that sort of stuff, you just find the word you want to emphasize, double click it, make it a caption, you're solid. And that's pretty much what there is to subtitles. Pretty simple, right? I hope you'll stick around with me, watch this next video, learn how to do some other cool stuff.